Welcome to exercise number 4 in the ground-based exercises to build hamstring strength and resilience series. This fourth exercise is that same exact eccentric ball curl we did a second ago, but instead of working on solely eccentric and that lengthening motion, we're gonna work on both directions. So far it's been isometric or eccentric. Now we're gonna add that concentric contraction, which means we're actually gonna pull the ball back. A little bit more challenging here because you're going to constantly be holding tension throughout the hamstring. There's really no rest period as you drop down. But on this one, again, you could start either way, legs extended or legs bent. I'm gonna start legs bent here. Using a little bit of support, I'm gonna lower away, again, control motion. And then as I pull back, I'm gonna pull back, but I'm gonna work on keeping the hips up in the air. So I'm always holding that hip bridge position as I'm shortening the hamstrings, and then I'm lengthening the hamstrings. So some actually find this exercise a little bit easier because it's not as slow and dreadful as the legs lengthen out away from the body. Some actually prefer this one. A couple key things that you'll see when performed incorrectly is lack of hip extension once again. So hips dropped in that position, hamstrings work so much harder because we're not getting any engagement through the glutes. Hamstrings are a little more lengthened because the hips are flexed. So definitely recommend getting up into full extension, holding that position, and then going both directions. Another thing will just be loss of stability. Now we're going lengthening away and pulling back. So if you're getting less arm support, either from the elbows or arms straight up, or there's no support and you're going through that motion, typically you can see here I'm swaying a little bit side to side. It's a little more challenging to stabilize. So a lot of these muscles through the core, hip and pelvis really have to tie in, do their job to maintain stability. So that is the fourth exercise in the series to build hamstring strength and resilience for runners.